involvement with that seems to be, I mean, it's one of the most, it's probably the most sort of powerful idea without going these days. And just, I was just wondering how you negotiate, or if you negotiate, or if you contemplate at all, the relationship you have to the kind of, or what the relationship is with the social or cultural capital that accrues to being in such a powerful position, and is that something that you think about, the sort of ethical implications of when you tell people you have these relationships with death, and do you ever use it to impress people, or?
Just you guys.
I asked this, I met this embalmer or a mortician once at a bar, and he seemed to rely on it as a way of impressing people, and I remember him once, he just said, he said, yeah, the worst is when it's a child. You would use these things to do really sensational things, and I was wondering if that's a temptation, or do you not resist that, or anything like that?
Do you ever use that as a pickup line?
No.
As a matter of fact,
are you aware of that as something that, because of the association is so powerful, and you have, you are powerful people in some ways, and does that occur to you?
No. As a matter of fact, in most of the locations that that I met people that they don't know what I do. When, as soon as I tell them I'm female director, they're gonna back me off of me.
Yeah.
The thing is that what we do in the funeral home, although it's something, like my job, okay, as far as I'm concerned, when the gentleman called me, I said I want to be here. I feel grateful to be invited because funeral is not supposed to be a secret. It's just supposed to be a public thing. And we want people to know what we do in the right way, not the wrong way. I mean, you know, there's articles in the newspaper saying, you know, female directors trying to scam money or trying to take advantage of people in the morning. But what we do at home, what we do in the funeral home, we don't bring it out just to impress or trying to tell people to scare people. And this is not what we're supposed to do. And if someone would do that, I would say that it's not a professionalism in its best. So I would say, if people ask me what is the worst thing I ever seen, or how you deal with you know, suicide and children death and things like that, I would tell them in general and saying that, of course, the hardest thing for people to accept or family to accept is someone who died of suicide or murder or children or infant death. It's the hardest for the family to accept, but I'm not going to tell them that yesterday I have a baby coming in here or I have a murder victim coming in here, have 6-7 gunshot wounds. This is not what we or what I'm supposed to disclose or supposed to tell people what I do. What I'm saying is that we do the best we can, and we'll adjust to each situation that comes to us, no matter how good or how bad the situation. Of course, there's no good situation in any way. I always said that you know, you don't say the same thing to the same person, and some might not accept it. I heard someone told me that, when their mother's funeral, someone tell them, your mother is in a better place now. I mean, for her, she hurts because if it's a better place, why don't we all go? Right? So that's why it goes back to what we do. We do as a funeral director is to listen more than we talk. Okay? And if people ask me, I'll tell them honestly what is going on and what we do. But we don't bring it out ourselves, try to impress or try to make a scene. And if that's what you
where do you back off from? Like you said, if you bring it up, sometimes people will back away from you, so you keep it quiet, and sometimes...
Oh, no, what I'm saying is, if they know what my profession is, okay, and if they ask me, what do you do? I say, funeral director, and they just, I don't want to talk about it, you know what I mean?
Sometimes keep it under wraps so that people...
Oh, yeah, I'll just let it go. I mean, you know, why would I want to bring it up and tell people what I do, or, you know, what's the worst situation I go through? This is my business, this is my secrets. I have to keep them because nobody wants, like our prep room is locked. Okay, just in case It's a private room that nobody's supposed to go in there except me. Okay, that's the respect we have to give to